everybody. This is Michelle Caswell from Purely His, and I am driving to town right now because I'm going to go visit one of our groups in Central Point, Oregon. And I am driving our pickup truck, which is, I don't even know what it is. It's like a 1992 or 94 or 97, whatever, Dodge Ram. And it's usually what we use just like on our little farm or to like haul things. But my husband took my keys to the other vehicle, so I have to drive this to town. And anyways, this thing like blows hot air instead of air conditioning. And every once in a great while, you'll get like a little blast of cold air. So even though I've only been driving for about 15 minutes, my shirt is already wet. And I'm sitting here thinking about my husband last night, how he was talking about like kind of his dream truck and the truck he really wants. And it's really expensive. And, you know, our other vehicles that we have are all, you know, at least 20 years old. I think we have one that might be like 19 years old. Anyways, and it's a weird thing about being in ministry because a lot of people will give you flack if you have anything nice. And so I always find myself downplaying what we have and telling people how much things cost or how little they cost, because I don't want anyone thinking that I'm taking people's donations or, you know, making money off of the Lord's work to have nice things. So, you know, somebody will go like, oh, I love your outfit. And I'm like, oh, thanks, $2 at a garage sale or $5 at Goodwill. Or somebody go, oh, that's a really cute car. Yeah, we got it for only $2,200. Or, wow, your house is so awesome. I can't believe you live like that, you know, and you're in ministry. It's like, yeah, well, we got it for only $214,000, and it's, you know, half the price of the houses in, you know, the area that we were actually looking. And anyways, this message is actually calling myself out and possibly my future self, because there is absolutely nothing wrong with having nice things, whether you paid full price or didn't pay full price, or whether they're really good quality or not such good quality. And there should be no reason why I should have to explain myself or feel guilty or ashamed for having nice things, or for wanting nicer things, or to want to drive a truck that actually has air conditioning, because today it is 106 degrees. So I am so dang hot right now. It's not even funny. I should have brought another shirt, but I forgot that the air conditioning was like this in this, or I should say the heat on full blast is like it. But anyways, you know, the Bible talks about that a worker is worth their wage. And at this time, you know, in our ministry, I've been doing this for 5 years now, as Purely His, as a nonprofit ministry. And for the first year, I only made $400 a month. And the second year and the third year, I think in the fourth year too, or whatever, I only made $800 a month. And now I just got a raise and I make $1,000 a month. And which is still only a tiny bit compared to all of the work that I put in, from the text messages when I'm mentoring people, from the Facebook messages. I spend hours every single day doing that. I meet with people for coffee. I go to visit groups like I am right now, which is a 3-hour round trip for me to get there and back. And I love doing that. And I do speaking engagements totally for free, or I'll do them for very little money. And I don't care because I love it. But I also shouldn't care when at some point I make a whole heck of a lot more than that, because someday I will. And so I'm just telling my future self, you have nothing to be ashamed of and you have nothing to feel guilty for, and you can have nice things and it is okay, and you don't need to explain yourself to nobody. So this also goes out to all my friends who are in ministry, or all those of you who are in ministry that I don't know yet. It is okay to be blessed by the Lord, to be highly favored by the Lord, and to have nice things. And we do not need to keep, you know, feeling bad about it. I know that a lot of people will make those YouTube videos and stuff, which I've seen, and that's part of the stuff that scares me, is they will really come down on people who are in ministry, who have nice things, or to spend money, or wear nice clothes, or have nice cars, or whatever. And I get that some of them have the wrong heart, or maybe some of them are doing it for the wrong reasons, or maybe it's a little bit too extravagant, whatever. But not everybody's like that. And yeah, I just really want to encourage everybody out there that people who are in ministry are allowed to make the same amount of money as people who aren't in ministry. People who are in ministry are doing their best to change the world. And I know that other people can work in a grocery store or a high-rise building or real estate agent or whatever, and I know that they can change the world in their own way as well. But this is just mostly for those ministers out there. So thanks for listening, and I hope you have a super awesome day. Bye.